Hey guys, I'm LB, and let's play Get Smart 10, Thinking is Required. If you're looking for the previous one, Get Smart 9, Back to Basics, I played that in my 256 subscriber special, so be sure to look there if you want to see that map. So let's see, let's read the description. I really recommend trying to figure it out before watching a walkthrough. The execution is not hard, but a very little bit of outside-of-box thinking is required. Enjoy! Difficulty depends on experience. Medium to hard? Walkthroughs up above, many thanks to Prototype, Seven Silhouettes, Flav, and Solid Gem for playing through every iteration of this thing. Let's get started.
I've been thinking. What if Greg was right?
Ooh. Hey, look at this. This is interesting. Looks like something to walk on, but why? Interesting. Why would we do that? Interesting. Let's just get all the interestings out of the way this episode so that we don't have to say them anymore for the rest of the episode. Interesting. One of these days, somebody, maybe me, but somebody is gonna make a montage of all the times I've said interesting throughout all my videos. I'm way too lazy to do it right now. Maybe for... I don't know... one of my subscriber specials. Like... I don't know... 1024? Who knows? Let's see, so to begin with... we can shoot that... and that'll get us over here, right? Yep, we're over here now. And we have a button that temporarily disables the fizzler. Why is that nestled back here behind a corner? Are these just decoration or are we actually supposed to be walking on them at some point? I think they're just decoration. We have a... button over here that can be pressed and can also get us a cube across, it seems. And then this is just if we fall in the hole. And we have a cube dropper, which I assume this button does, yes indeed. Oops, I didn't want to walk in the funnel, I wanted to put the cube in the funnel. Alright. And then, let's see. I actually want to do this. So let me get that cube back real quick. I'm amazed that the great glitch did not just take effect. Alright, and then... we can do this. What avail? Oh, I see. So then we do that. We've got the cube over here now. I think that's worth saving over, right? First of all, what does this do? That does the exit. Good to know. And this does... reverse the funnel, and... okay... why is there a light bridge here? What activates this? That is very mysterious, actually. I wanna go back over. Is weird. You know what? I didn't even notice that that was there. How would we get there? Because this is the only portal surface without a grate, and that's the only other portal surface without a grate. Everything else has grating. Even the people who have played this map already have grating teeth. Back over to the other side by loading our quick save. You know what I think I should have done? I think I should have left my portal there so that I could pull myself back over with the cube on the button still. So we will have to redo that part of the puzzle, but whatever. That's fine. Outside of the box does not mean abusing glitches, so we definitely do not want to abuse funnel flying. That would be weird. Hang on a second. Can we press that button from anywhere? Yeah, we should be able to press that button through the portal, right? But which portal is close enough? Yeah, all these portal surfaces are backed away intentionally so that we can't do that. So we could press that pedestal button through the portal, but we don't have any close enough portals. Okay, well first of all, let's do my other theory and restart this whole contraption. Okay, so now... we can't carry the cube through the glass. That's too high, even if we jumped on the cube. Now, let's just go back. That's not gonna work. That is interesting. And it disables only the top half of the fizzlers. That light bridge is probably why, and I'm assuming that that button activates the light bridge. I have an idea. And it is thinking outside the box, I believe. Definitely not a glitch. But oh my gosh, is it gonna be hard? Ish. Maybe. Let's try that again. Not necessarily hard, but just precise. Hey! I did it. I heard a flip panel. Where did that flip panel sound come from? Why did I hear a flip panel? Wait a second, I don't even think that helped me at all. That's not really any different from what I had earlier, actually. Now that I think about it, that's actually not helpful. It is outside the box, but what was that flip panel? I swear I heard a flip panel. In fact, I know I heard a flip panel. Let's do that again. I want to know what causes that flip panel sound. Is it just outside logic, or what is it? Wait a second. Oh my gosh, get me out of this funnel, please. So if we do this, right? Look at that! What could that be for? I didn't even notice that before. Oh, I know what that's for, never mind. That's so that when the funnel is reversed, we can't walk along the edge there. Of course, that would be potentially useful. Yeah. Okay, that's what that's for. And I cannot get up here fast enough to make that happen. It might be possible, theoretically, but there's no way I'm gonna be able to do it. And I don't think it's intended. Why else would it be too high? Let's read this again. The execution is not hard, but a very little bit of outside-of-box thinking is required. Here's the thing, I don't think I can get into this funnel from where I am. As far as I know, that button only opens the exit, nothing else. What else could be outside of the box? I can't get up here. And I'm not even sure how useful it would be to do that anyway. Because I can get over there both with and without the cube on the button. And we can also stand on the ledge and change it to our own will, but that doesn't really seem useful at all. I want to try going back to the other side with the funnel reversed again. Did I ever mention that I'm not good at funnel puzzles? Why is this underneath a grating? There's that, but that doesn't really help at all. And I don't really think it's supposed to be possible anyway. Like, we can get here, but that doesn't help at all. Does not help at all. Also, I did not realize that the glass was actually slightly thinner than the frame. Today I learned. Heh Yeah, even with funnel flying, I'm not really sure how it helps, in the slightest. Because you can't go up at all. You can't go up or down. Being here does not really... not help at all, really. Actually... no, that won't work. Never mind. Does funnel flying work, like, here? Maybe not. Yeah, I definitely think funnel flying is not count as outside of the box. I think it counts as outright cheating. I feel really dumb. There's something that I have not even tried. But I don't think it'll help. Like, I could get the cube- I could be in here, and I could direct the cube onto the button, get the funnel reversed while I'm in this room. But... I don't think it will help. Like, there's nothing in here that I would want to use a reversed funnel with. so I actually don't feel really dumb. Why is this under a grating? I don't understand. Not sure how the light bridge is meant to help either. That's something. That looks like it's outside of the box, literally. Alright, we'll work on that assumption. That'll get me up there. How long does this last? Oh, and it's only at the bottom, so never mind. There we go. This is somewhere I've not been yet. Yep, and the game lags, so that's definitely the light bridge. Yep. Oh, wait. This fizzler's off permanently now? That's interesting. So here's the question, right? I'm up here. How do I get the cube and stay up here? Oh, duh. That's what this is for. We did it! Reddit. Alright, so now we just need to get up here, right? Yes, I see how this works now. I think. Maybe. Thank you. fell off. Alright. Let's try that again, and I don't wanna reload quick save because that takes too long. Let's see. Let's throw this past the- oh, well, that, that is one way to do that the wrong way. Alright, let's do this now. Perfect. And then do that. Oh, but we can't. Oh, and I stuck myself. There we go. I unstuck myself. Can't see the portal surface though, which is an issue. Oh hey, look at that! End of the day, we wanna raise- like, we wanna push the cube over here, raise it, and then do this, which we can all do from up here. The question is actually getting ourselves up there in the first place. That's what I don't understand. Actually, what does happen now if the cube goes on the button? Nothing special. Am I some kind of moron? I am not a moron. Jeez. Wow. Told you I'm not good with funnels. Alright, we've done that. So now... do that, right? There we go. Well guys, as always, thank you for watching this special 40-minute episode. As always, if you hate the sound of my voice, leave a dislike, it's up to you, and I will see you all in the next episode. Goodbye! I'm gonna add that to my favorites.